When Mitt Romney goes off the teleprompter, starts speaking off the cuff, he has a record of promptly stepping in it. Just yesterday, he was asked if he follows NASCAR. He told the Associated Press, quote, not as closely as some of the most ardent fans, but I do have some friends who are NASCAR team owners. Then there was a botched campaign event in his home state of Michigan Friday. 1,200 people showed up at a football stadium that seats 65,000. Romney told the handful of supporters he drives cars made in Michigan.
I like the fact that most of the cars I see are Detroit-made automobiles. I drive a Mustang and a Chevy pickup truck. Ann drives a couple of Cadillacs, actually. And I used to have a Dodge truck, so I used to have all three covered.
This is not how you connect with blue-collar workers in Detroit. It's no wonder he's in a dead heat with Rick Santorum ahead of tomorrow's primary in his home state. In that same speech, Romney made a repeated and rather bizarre comment about why he loves Michigan, saying it feels good to be back home in Michigan, quote, where the trees are the right height. Whatever the hell that means. It appears Romney has a serious problem when he goes off script. He sounds out of touch, elite, or just plain strange. Examples abound. He has said that he's, quote, not concerned about the very poor, that there's a safety net in place for them. Romney said he likes, quote, being able to fire people who provide services to me, in reference to choosing between different health insurance companies. He made that infamous $10,000 bet with former candidate Rick Perry during an early debate. It's estimated Romney's worth about $200 million. In response to the gaffe about the cars he drives, Romney says he can't be perfect, quote, I just am who I am. He adds there's nothing wrong with being successful in America. He wants to use his success to help the American people. So here's the question. Should Mitt Romney be allowed to go off teleprompter? Go to CNN.com/Cafferty file, post a comment on my blog, or go to our post on the Situation Room's Facebook page. Wolf.